Namaste viewers, welcome to Gnanadegula channel. We are going through the meaning of certain terms in this series of videos so that it will be easy for us to understand, or we'll know the meaning of those words, philosophical words, so that it will be easy for us to understand when we go deeper into those subjects. Here, today we will discuss about adhyasa, or it is also called as adhyAropa. That means superimposition. This is an important idea in Advaita Vedanta. So this helps us understand why we identify, or we mistakenly identify ourselves with our body and mind instead of realizing our true nature as the self. Let us see how it is in a little more detail. So adhyasa is superimposition. What is that superimposition? Let us try to understand through some kind of examples only. You imagine you are walking in a very dim light area, dim lit area, or total darkness, and you just feel a rope. If it is dim light, you can see a rope. Otherwise, if it is totally dark, you can feel something, some rope-like thing on the ground. Because you do not know what it is, you think it's a snake and become scared. So, if you analyze this, what is the reality? The rope is the real thing. The mistake is, we have mistaken this. We think that the rope is a snake. This is your superimposition, overlaying the idea of a snake onto the reality of a rope. It's actually a rope, but you are thinking that it is a snake. The same way, the self, your true nature is infinite, changeless, pure consciousness, all those things. But you superimpose, you wrongly think that you are the body, mind, intellect, everything that presently you are seeing. No? These are all changing. All these things will change, and they are limited to only certain time and certain this thing. So this is the true self is different. It is changeless, infinite, pure consciousness, something like that. This confusion is called as adhyasa. Vedanta calls this as adhyasa. That means mixing up what is real, your true self, and what is not, your body and mind. And your misunderstanding, rather misunderstanding what is real and what is not. So, why do we mistake like this, do mistakes like this, commit mistakes? It is a kind of inapprehension. We fail to recognize our true nature as the self, just like failing to see the rope clearly. And the second fact is misapprehension. Inapprehension and misapprehension also. We wrongly identify ourselves with the body and mind, just like mistaking the rope for a snake. These two are the mistakes. When your body grows old or something, you know, it falls as sick. You think I am getting old, you think I am getting sick. When your mind feels confused, you think I am stupid. But these changes are only happening to the body, present body, mind, not to the true, what is true, what true you. This is eternal and unchanging. So, the great master Sri Sri Adi Shankaracharya in Advaita explains the process in detail. The subject, that is you, you are the conscious observer, the unchanging witness of everything. The object is different. Subject, object. Object is world, body, mind. All these things are objects. The objects you perceive, including your own body and mind, are external to you. They are not you. This is how it is to be understood. Adhyasa. We mix them up. we just put all these qualities, superimpose all these qualities of the body, mind, which are changing, onto that self, which is unchanging, which is eternal. I am tall, I am sad, all those things, you know, so many things. I am intelligent, I am stupid, all kinds of feelings, all kinds of feelings from the body, feelings in the mind, and body changes. I am beautiful, I look ugly, or I look smart, all those kinds of things, you know, they are not eternal. This mistake creates the illusion of a false self, a combination of the real self, I am, and the unreal attributes of the body and mind. These two are the combinations. So now, how to correct this mistake? Now we have understood that the mistake, what is this and all those things. But how to overcome this, and then how to understand what, how to correct this thought? For that, you have to understand the real and unreal. Just like realizing the rope is not a stake, understand that your body and mind are temporary and not the real you. It is always, it should always be reminding it. It should remind you. Your true nature is self, the eternal consciousness that remains unchanged. Disentangle that mix up. So you are getting entangled. You are just connecting yourself. You just disconnect. See, when you say, I am a shopkeeper, I am such and such a person, I am that, I am this, and all these things is the unreal part. I am so and so, I am so. All these things are unreal part. So now you have to practice discrimination. That means viveka. You have to be very, very vivekin. Learn to distinguish between the eternal, the self, and the temporary. Body, mind, roles, all those kinds of things. Only with practice, one can realize that the self is pure awareness, unaffected by the ups and downs of life. This is how you have to bifurcate yourself with the self. They present all this body, mind, self, and body, mind, soul, all those things. Body, mind, intellect, all those kinds. You know. You have to separate it from the what we call that Ātman or something like that. So now, think yourself as the sun. The sun is constant, shining brightly, unaffected by the clouds and that sometimes cover it. The body, mind, emotions are like passing clouds. They may obscure the light temporarily, but the sun, that you are true self, remains unchanged. The key is to stop identifying with the clouds and realize you are the ever-shining sun. So like this, by learning and reflecting on this teaching, you gradually free yourself from the illusion of being the body, mind, or mind, and come to know your true infinite nature. So, viewers, this is the meaning of adhyasa. This is how we have to understand adhyasa, the meaning of this philosophical term. With this, we'll conclude this episode. Please like, share, and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.